Hi, my name is Steve Kinney, and this is a course on building desktop applications using Electron. Electron allows you to use both Node.js as well as Chrome to interact directly with the file system, as well as build UIs using web technologies. In this course, we'll learn how to build applications that integrate with the host OS, from Mac OS, Windows, and Linux. We'll learn how to read and write to the file system and trigger native file dialogs, create applications that live in the menu bar or system tray. You'll learn how to create applications in the same vein as Visual Studio Code, Slack, Notion, the GitHub app, Obsidian, and more. I can't wait to see the amazing apps that you build using Electron.
I noticed that a lot of these other Electron apps, they got like the fancy menu bars that they made themselves, like the VS Code one or the GitHub one. The GitHub one's got some gradients, not, you know, not to be whatever. It's looking a little dated, but you know. I think Slack has got like a custom one nowadays. I want to get in on that. And I feel like I got almost all the way there, except I've got this like menu bar as well. And also this application feels like this is like the correct size for it. I don't want to deal with the fact that someone can stretch it out like this or like this. That's not, you know, ideally like this should keep track of things that I want to save to the clipboard. So I can say like important, like quip that I want to reuse a lot. And I should be able to like hit copy, but like this feels like an app that should be like roughly like that wide, right? Like, and so I wanna like have a little bit more control over this window than I previously have had in the past. So you can imagine the initial width and height are set here as well. And through the magic of TypeScript, we've got probably, you can get a sense of like some of the other ones. Hidden in mission control, obviously that's a macOS only one. Is it minimizable at all, right? So we'll say that the min height, I don't want to deal with it getting too like, I think this way I can make it pretty squirrely if I really put my mind to it. I'm pretty sure I could do something like that. I don't want to allow that. That's gross. That's, yeah, right? Like nobody wants that. So we'll say that the min height, I think the min height is only going to be like no less than 400 feels right. Same thing for the width. I don't need to live by that. 300 feels right there. The max, let's see, max height, 800. I'm making values up to be very clear with you. Max width, you know what? 450. We'll see if this looks good at all. And you know what? They can't maximize it. So it's not, they can minimize it. I don't care. It's not maximizable at all. So we'll start with that and see what we got. All right. So now I missed it. There it is. Can't go any bigger than 450. Can't get any smaller than 300. Cool. So I've got some like reasonable like settings here. Feels like good. I do want to get like one of those custom menu bar dealies. That feels nice. So with that, I'm simply going to say that the title bar style is hidden, and that there is a title. Like I still like. Let's see what happens if I just do that. I think I still need to like do one more tweak to get it to look totally right. We'll find out together. That looks pretty good. The other one I was going to do is and we'll put that to true. And you can see like, and there's documentation for all this kind of stuff. You can also read it here as well. I want them visible as well. And there's a bunch of other like settings in here. And that should get me most of the way there. But we're going to notice something gross, which is now I want to drag this thing. But like it's behaving like a web page, which is disgusting. I didn't go through all of this work to create something that looked and felt like a web app, not to be able to drag the title bar, right? And I don't want to select that. And like, no, that's not the behavior that I've come to know and love. You can see that I can't maximize it though. That's cool. And to everyone's shock and amazement, do you know how we fix this? CSS. Yeah, we fix it with CSS. So with a little bit of CSS, we can adjust this. I happen to know that I gave it the ID of title bar. So That is not a built-in Electron thing. That is just simply, I happen to be the person who wrote the HTML. So there's basically two things we want to do. We want to do user select and none. And the other one is webkit.app-app-region, which is to say that this title bar is a thing you can drag this window by, right? And so now we're saying that, like, don't select the text in the title bar there, and also treat that entire title bar, which is what that div has the idea of, as a thing that we can drag as part of the app. So yeah, WebKit, app, region, and now look at that thing. It's like a menu bar or a title bar, whatever it's supposed to be. Now I can drag this around like it's a real app, like all of its friend app over here, right? I can do the same thing. I'm now hanging out with the cool kids in this sense. So we can write to the clipboard, we can copy from the clipboard. The other thing that we can do is we can register global shortcuts. Right, so you saw before when I made an application menu, I could have an accelerator like Command or Control O, right, that would trigger that file menu. But that's obviously only while you're in the app, right? What would be cool is if I wanted, let's say this was holding memes instead of like deep thoughts that I wanted to copy and paste. What if I wanted to be able to, like, at a moment's notice, select something, hit a keystroke, and have it saved in there, right? Or like something along those lines from anywhere, right? And there are applications we probably have on our computers like, cool, when I add a new calendar event, whatever keystroke thing pops up or to-do list thing or what have you. We can do that. That's totally possible in an Electron app in a way that's not possible in a browser app. And to no one's surprise, also shockingly easy. So we've got this thing called the global shortcut module. It does what it says on the tin, right? It registers global shortcuts. We do need to make sure that our application is ready. Right now, that is just simply creating a window for the first time. So what we do need to do is to say, well, we still want to create a window. But then also, we want to register global shortcut. As you can see, like, it, GitHub Copilot knows that I have now, like, built this app about 5 times. In the last week and knows what I'm going to type next, which is super helpful. In this case, and again, you can choose, you know your computer better than me to know, like, what keystrokes are not currently registered by something else that you have some weird conflict. But in this case, like, you basically can go ahead, register a global shortcut with the same kind of accelerator syntax that we saw before. Right, and we could do something like, content is read whatever's on the clipboard, and then what we want to do is send it, or like, let's even just do the simplest possible thing right now. Like, again, you know how the IPC stuff works. You can send a message to, in this case, our one browser window. You can get the currently focused browser window, right? This application strikes me as one where I only ever want one browser window, so I might choose to move some of that logic and store it in a variable at the top scope. And you can send a message to it and then say, like, oh, as this comes in. Before we registered the handler, like, oh, on file open. In a React app, we might choose to, for instance, have a use effect hook, right? Component mounts. Start listening for anything over the channel saying, oh, a new clipping has come in, and then add it into the store the same way we would in a React app. Let's just do the simplest possible thing right now, because I think it, like, how you wire up the different pieces, like, is stuff we've covered over and over again so far. But I think, like, the idea of registering the global shortcut and seeing it in place. So at this point, we'll just say, like, I mean, that's going to be the main window. Browser window. Let's just go ahead, like, the return value of that create window. And we'll just say browser window.show. Sir window.focus. So like from anywhere, I just even want to pull the app up as the foremost thing. I think I'm trying to remember if I need to also like, if I want to be able to like make the application, I think it's app. Yeah, well, let's also focus the app as well. So this should theoretically, this is a live decision I've made at the moment. Command control shift C, just because I don't know what I've got registered, I'm also going to say alt. So I've got to hit command control shift option C. I don't think that does anything else on my computer presently. So we'll find out. The other thing that I will say that you do need to do is like app dot on quit or will quit somewhere along those lines in the life cycle. You probably want to do global shortcut unregister all. Right? You register them when the app is quitting. You should give them back to the OS because it's polite. So we'll have those two pieces in place. And we'll just do npm start again. Cool. And ideally, what I want to do is go over here. Oh, look at that. I'm somewhere else. I'm finding stuff. I have a thought. I'm going to go over back over to GitHub. I'm going to hit Command. Option shift C clip master, right? And now it is ready to go and I can copy something from the clipboard.